Following the Industrial Revolution in the 19th century. Pollution should not be taken with levity. Pollution must be taken seriously because it causes negative effects on our natural elements. Natural elements such as water, land, and air. Hello and welcome. This is Growing Up. Growing Up is a program designed for the youth and the upcoming generation. This is a program that avails our young minds the opportunity to air their stance on topics related to character development and human capacity building. This program is reaching you from NTA Channel 12, your dependable station. We join the rest of the world to mark and celebrate the World Environment Day with the theme, Beat Plastic Pollution. Today, we are privileged to have students from the prestigious University of Uyo here to compete and negotiate on the motion which says, can plastic pollution be eradicated, yes or no? So, chemistry students are saying, yes, it can be eradicated. While urban and regional planning students are saying, never, it cannot be eradicated. So, who will win? Do the yes or the no? You want to know? Very simple. Why not sit back, relax, and watch? Because it promises to be very educated, informative, and exciting. Once again, thank you for joining us. Emma Miriam Septisper is my name. Ladies and gentlemen, it is with great pleasure that I welcome upstage a very diligent, smart, and intelligent young man as a moderator for today. He is no other person than Godspar Monday Judge. Please put hands together.
Thank you, Miriam. Today's debate is quite an exceptional one because right here in the studio we have decently dressed undergraduates from the University of Uyo, Nigeria, to establish their stance on the focus, can plastic pollution be eradicated, yes or no? If I may ask, can plastic pollution really be eradicated from our environment?
No!
Order!
Wow, interesting, isn't it? Why not sit down, relax, and experience the delight, as Growing Up promises to be informative, educative, and as well, entertaining. My name is Godspar Monday Judge, and I'm glad to be the moderator for today's debate. Speaking in favor of this motion are undergraduates of the Department of Chemistry, and the lead speaker for that school is Victoria Michael Moran. And also speaking against the motion are undergraduates from the Department of Urban and Regional Planning, and the lead speaker for that school is Goodness Godwin Titus. No, please, with smiles on your faces, put your hands together for them. It is my utmost delight to welcome and recognize well-respected personalities and dignitaries in our midst. First on my list is our very own sponsor, the chairman of today's event, a father, and he is also the chairman of Akwa Ibom State Local Government Service Commission. I'm talking about no other person than Sir Dr. Valentine Attar. Also in our midst, we have the director of NTA Channel 12 with your dependable TV station in person of Mrs. Patricia Givenon. Thank you very much. We are most grateful to have you in our midst. Thank you for joining us. Now to the introduction of the panel of judges, because before we start, it is pertinent we know them. First on my list from my immediate left is Mrs. Bella Emanson. She is a staff of the Department of Climate Change and Awareness, Ministry of Environment and Mineral Resources. Next we have Professor Ekanem. He is a climatologist from the Department of Geography and Natural Resources Management, University of Uyo. And finally, we have Mrs. Priska Udo. She is the Director of Education at Akwa Ibom State Service Commission. Please put your hands together for her. Having known the panel of judges, it is time to know the rules, the criteria, and all the needed necessary information for this debate. So put your hands together as I invite the Chief Judge to please give us those information.
I want to give you the ground rules and how we're going to judge you. First, your appearance and your dressing, we will look at it and score you. The points you raise will be recorded and we will score you based on how many points you raise. How you manage your time, because you're given a time, you can't do everything all the time. So you have a time space to manage. We will take into consideration your management of time. We'll look at how you comport yourself, your comportment while delivering your speech. And then we'll look at the fluency at which you're delivering your speech. Those are the things we're going to consider to score you in this very important debate. Thank you, and I hope you keep to it.
Thank you very much. Looking at the faces of these participants, you will agree with me that they are so ready to take on each other. But first, let's get to know the time formation for this debate. Join your hands together and welcome the timekeeper as she takes the stage.
Are you motivated?
Motivated, motivated, motivated.
Growing in integrity.
Dignity for all.
My name is Victory Great, and I'm the timekeeper. Please listen attentively to the time formation. The lead speakers have 4 minutes each. The first and second supporting speakers have 3 minutes each. For the reply speech, the lead speakers have 2 minutes each. The whistle indicates that points of information to commence. The first bell indicates that points of information should stop, and you have 1 minute left to conclude. The second bell means your time is up. Please adhere strictly to the time formation. Good luck.
Growing up.
Growing integrity.
Thank you very much. And now is the time for the speakers to make their points heard. We'll begin with the lead speaker from the proposing team, in person of Victoria Michael Umorin.
The chairman, dignitaries here present, Mr. Mojeto, panel of judges, accurate timekeeper, co-debaters, my audience. I'm Victoria Michael Umorin, an undergraduate student, department of representing the Department of Chemistry, University of Uyo, and I'm proposing the motion that says that plastic waste can be eradicated. Before I go any further, I would like to define some keywords: plastic pollution and plastic pollution in general. Plastic pollution is the introduction of plastic into the environment excessively at a level that is no longer desirable. It kills our land, gets into our water, the fishes eat it up. And one evening, you'll probably be serving plastic and dinner disguised as a fish. One would say, plastic is cheap, plastic is durable, but the disadvantage greatly outweighs the advantage. Plastic is a culprit in many health challenges like hormonal imbalance, cancer and other adverse health effects. And then, it affects the ecosystem, which is already fragile. Statistics has it that at 2017, the waste plastic waste produced in Nigeria was about 443,000, which is a staggering amount. And as at 2020, this figure is expected to increase to about 513,000 kilotons. Yes, it is outrageous, but be relaxed, because when there is a will, there is always a way. Plastic pollution can be eradicated. How? Through the following ways. Firstly, we use the 4R rules: rejecting, reducing, reusing, and recycling. There are great alternatives to plastic materials. We have your paper bag, we have the jute bag, we have the clothes bag, and we have nanocomposites that can be used to package your food in place of the plastic materials used. These alternatives should be encouraged. The continuous use of this alternative in place of the plastic ones will help reduce the amount of plastic used in production. Also, another way of curbing this menace is through sensitization. I'll take this.
Please, when they define your keywords, you never made mention of eradication.
When I said I was getting to that, I was explaining plastics and I was explaining pollution. I am getting to the ways which eradicate plastic, and in the process, I am going to also define that as a term in my explanation. But let me answer you. Eradication is the way of curbing a menace, something that is of adverse effect to your environment or adverse effect to you as a person. Your curbing is the process in which you curb that effect is called eradication. Have I answered your question? I will continue. People should be sensitized. It is not just the government alone. We should take it as a collective effort, individually. Educate your household, educate yourself. NGOs should take it upon themselves to educate people. This will help if people are aware of their disposal methods. Yes, plastic pollution is a menace, but it can be curbed and eradicated. Thank you very much.
That was very, very remarkable. Please, put your hands together for her one more time. And it's your turn, the lead speaker from the opposing team.
Good day, Mr. Chairman, the moderator, panel of judges, accurate architects, my co-debaters, and my distinguished audience. My name is Goodness Dobby Tess, a student of the Department of Urban and Regional Planning, Faculty of Environmental Studies, University of the U.S. I'm here to say no to the motion which says, can plastic pollution be eradicated? First of all, I want to make you understand what it means, what you think eradicate means. According to the Manorita Dictionary, as of May 2016, define the term eradicate to do away completely as possible from something. Also, in Cookborn, 1961, in the book Disease Eradication, defines eradication as the elimination of harmful pathogens that causes a harmful disease. So long as any trace or piece of that pathogen exists, eradication is said to have been accomplished. Also, according to the Cambridge Advanced Science Dictionary of 2018, eradicate means to get rid of something bad completely. So we are not saying we want to eradicate plastic pollution without removing the root cause of plastic pollution, that is the pathogen, plastic. For the past 3 to 4 decades, plastic has played an inevitable use in the lives and activities of human beings. From houses, homes, offices, and everywhere we stay, plastic is being found. The inevitable use of plastic, human activities on plastic, and the adverse effects on the conventional tools are what my first and second supporting speakers are going to discuss on extensively. But let me bring to your notice. According to the World Bank publication on solid waste management as of 2013, it said that increase in waste management leads correspondingly to increase in population or increase in urbanization leads correspondingly to increase in waste generated. So we cannot say that as long as we have increased the population, we are always going to have yes, I think it.
So far, you've not succeeded in saying any reasons why, concrete reasons why you're saying it cannot be eradicated.
I'm getting to that.
You said something about it can be eradicated if the pathogen plastic is being taken away. So that means if we stop plastic, we can eradicate it.
Yes.
Thank you.
Also, as I was saying, plastic saves many uses. Also, according to the World Bank publication that we say, as of 2012, the world population was 7 billion and the world generated 1.3 billion tons of waste. And also in 2025, it's estimated that the world is going to generate 2.2 billion tons of waste, because the population would have increased to 8.1 billion. So we show that increase in population leads correspondingly to increase in waste. As long as we cannot stop the population of human society, we cannot stop the generation of waste management, which plastic itself is being seen as waste management. Under the auspices of NESRA, National Environmental Standard Regulation Enforcement Agency, National Environmental Regulation of 2009 was promulgated. This law prohibits people from dropping plastics, waste and plastic materials on the way while walking or while traveling, given the power by the citizens, cannot efface a little thing like plastic pollution, then who are we? Also, let me quote the Daily Trust newspaper as of 28 March 2018. A former minister was quoted as saying that government has made provisions in place to efface of plastic pollution. This quotation was made back in 2018. If plastic has been eradicated since 2018, we wouldn't have been here discussing about plastic pollution. That means government lacked the political will to do what she has said. So, as of 2009, the regulation was made. 2013, the pronunciation was made. But what to have you? And what do you think that 2018 there'll be any difference? I bet you there'll be a difference. As long as there is lack of will on the part of government, I don't think plastic can be eliminated. So the theme eradication. Also, I want to put to you that theme eradication does not mean control. I hope with this point of mind, I'll be able to convince you that plastic cannot be eradicated.
Sensational, isn't it? Please put your hands together for him. We have listened to the lead speakers. Up next, we'll be listening to first supporting speakers. But we'll do that after this short timeout. Please, stay with us.
Growing up is a program that promotes value-based education and noble moral standards in the upcoming generation, as they are the leaders of tomorrow.
If I may ask, is deforestation really the major cause of climate change?
Yes!
Volcanic, isn't it? I love that.
Growing up, a debate special and unique.
Growing up, coming up every Sunday on NTA Channel 12, your dependable station. Growing up, raising young minds for the future. For inquiries and sponsorship, please call 0806-429-4907.
For comments and contribution, do like our Facebook page on www.facebook.com/growingup.debate.
Growing up, a must watch for everyone.
Welcome back. It's still Growing Up. This is Growing Up, reaching you from your dependable TV station. Growing Up is a platform that entertains, informs, and educates as well. It also gives opportunity for one to express him or herself in public speaking and on subject matters and also related topics. Are we motivated?
Motivated, motivated, motivated.
The lead speakers have ignited the fire, and I hope the second supporting speakers and the first supporting speakers will keep the fire burning. Now the first supporting speaker proposing team. Let's hear from you.
My name is Daisy Claude Nwoa from University of Uyo Chemistry Department. I'm here to support the motion that says, can plastic pollution be eradicated? Yes, it can be eradicated. Yes, it can be eradicated. If we eradicate our plastic waste, we give attention to our more developing. We give eradication to our more developing eco-friendly substitutes. One, protein plastics. Researchers have said that casein, a protein found in leguminous plants, can be used to produce biodegradable material for use in insulation, for use in packaging, and for use in protein in other protein products. It is also edible, and according to Bloomberg, it is 500 times better than conventional products. It is 500 times better than conventional products used in...
One information. Please, I want to remind you, my co-debater, that we are looking at, or we are talking about eradication, not the use of plastic, or the chemistry of plastic. Can you educate us more on eradication, not the use of plastic?
I'm not talking about the use of plastic. I'm bringing out measures that we use instead of the main plastic we have already. That is the biodegradable materials that we can use to eradicate this plastic pollution we're talking about. I continue. According to Bloomberg, it is 500 times better than conventional plastics that we use, as it forms a tighter network when it polymerizes.
Plastics are
For plastics include single-serve, edible food, and other products. Again, plastic additives. Biodegradable thermoplastics can be used in compound additives known as pro-degradant additives that undergo an oxidation process that disintegrate and turn into carbon dioxide, integrate and turn into water and other plastic products. It does not contain any harmful residue, and as such, these products consist of the materials we use, such as shopping bags and landfill covers. Again, changing customers' behavior. Customers should be told to return our reusable cups after use. For instance, in France, customers are being told to return their reusable cups when being served coffee at the coffee shop at 15 naira, and 30 naira refund will be given back to the customer when the reusable cups will be returned. It is high time we stop calling these cups disposable cups. Rather, we should call them or term them reusable cups. With this mentality, I know that plastic pollution can be eradicated. Thank you.
That was a very good one. Please applaud her. Thank you very much. The first supporting speaker from the opposing team, the platform is all yours.
Good afternoon, the chairman, moderator, panel of judges, accurate timekeeper, co-debaters, and audience. My name is Faith Iterosiloman from the Department of Urban and Regional Planning, Faculty of Environmental Studies, University of Rio. I am here to further say no to the motion that plastic pollution cannot be eradicated with the following. I start with what my first speaker said from the opposing side. She said that one of the methods of eradicating plastic pollution is the use of 4 R's. Of which one is reuse. The concept that comes along reuse is that if you cannot reuse it, refuse it. How about the syringe? How about the contraceptives? How about the pads? Do we reject them also? I go back to my point. Consumer behavior.